Hello, Mother Patrice.
Sarah Hawk, it is good to see you. The shame that Vael brought his order is most unfortunate. Praise the Maker that you were his champion in that dark place.
No thanks to you, and you know it.
I gave you Vael.
And a room full of zealots.
He recruited with the promise of Chantry blessing. You weren't going to argue them out of salvation. Vael stepped too far. But the faithful know that eternity is at stake. Though there are, perhaps, better ways to go about it.
I can't let this go that easy.
Then we are destined to have this argument again. For now, I have made no criminal claims, and even your Viscount considers this matter closed. If he is good at anything, it is doing nothing. I hope you live a long life, Sarah Hawk, because your judgment before the Maker will be harsh.
Sometimes you just know trouble is coming.
I thought it would end here. That young lady, Hawk, she decimated Flint Company. No survivors. Yet, now that I know who sent them, it's harder to see their deaths as justice.
Death is never justice.
My... Hawk, we were just talking about you.
Saying good things, I hope.
Many people in Kirkwall have good things to say about you.
I've learned who hired Flint Company. The Harrimanns, a noble family of Kirkwall. They were my parents' allies. It's hard to believe they betrayed us like this.
Did Lord Harriman die violently? About 3 years ago?
I won't ask how you know that.
I had heard he was murdered. His daughter took over the family, Lady Johane Harriman. They say she's become quite reclusive of late.
Any idea why they turned on you?
Money? Power? It's hard to say. Lady Harriman was always jealous of my family for being royalty when hers were mere nobility. But I can't imagine that pushing her into outright murder.
Is there any peaceful way to resolve this?
If you treat the Harrimanns like those mercenaries, you could start a war. Go carefully, Sebastian.
I must speak with Lady Harriman and find out what drove her to this madness. But I am the last of my line. I should not go alone and make myself a target.
If I'm standing beside you, that should make her think twice.
Again, your interest in my plight humbles me. If you like, I can travel with you until you confront Lady Harriman. Otherwise, you can always find me here in the Chantry.
You're glaring, Anders. Is there a reason, or is it one of your moods?
Your term as captain hasn't been particularly mage-friendly.
I've only turned a handful over to the Templars.
Every despot starts somewhere.
And yet I allow an abomination to whine at me. Credit where it's due.
I understand you are of noble birth.
My father was a chevalier. He had to flee Orlais when his patron was murdered.
I'm sorry.
I wouldn't have been suited for the life of an Orlesian noblewoman anyway.
But surely you wish it had been different. To be a lady of Orlais and not a city guardsman.
Not for one moment. I'd rather kill a bandit and save a merchant's family than know the correct dance steps and which rouge is in fashion.
That's strange. The door's wide open. And not a single guard posted. This is not the Lady Harriman I remember. There is something very wrong in here.
More, you lazy!
lazy son of a bitch! What's taking so long?
Flora?
Why does no one in this house care what I want? More wine, or I swear I will drown you in the dregs.
She doesn't even see us. This is no normal wine.
More locks. It must be molten. You, more coins. I want every scrap of gold in this house.
Please, Monsieur!
There's nothing to fear. You'll be beautiful. Pour it over her.
Don't! You'll kill her! He can't hear me.
Perhaps I should be the one.
We must end this madness. I visited this house often as a child. They could not have concealed such goings-on.
Oh! Lower! Lower!
I beg your pardon, Hawk. I did not mean to expose you to such things.
No! The feather! Use the feather! Where have you been all my life? Today, I am more than a man. Come, felicitate me!
He has no idea we're here. I've known Ruxton Harriman my whole life. He's a complete prude.
Where's your brother? Let's ask him to join us.
You know what they say about a man with big hands. Now, you be the naughty apprentice, and I'll be the Templar torch.
Turn back. There is nothing here for you.
You're not in a strong negotiating position.
You shall not enter.
Temptresses. We must see what greater evil they were protecting.